Over the years, I've made videos about quite a few products that turned out to be useless, but this is the first product I've bought which proudly says that it's useless on the box. It's the Useless Machine Kit from Spikenzielabs. Now, I've made a few of their kits in the past and normally they require soldering, but this one doesn't. The electronics are pre-soldered, you just have to assemble all the other stuff. So, no holes in the carpet with this one, but you do need a flat blade screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, and three AAA batteries. Now, I was quite surprised when I got inside the box to find that there was an instruction booklet in there. Spikenzielabs always put together instructions, but usually they're PDFs that you have to download from their website. They don't normally print them out. So this is a nice addition, full colour, very easy to follow, nice step-by-step guide. Excellent thing to put together perhaps with a child and they can learn a little bit about electronics perhaps or mechanics or just have fun. Now let's have a look what's inside the box other than the instructions. Well, this is the battery compartment. That's a motor. That's a bag of stuff. That's a thingamajig. There's a whatchamacallit. And there's a bag of gubbins. Oh, and there's a little thing here that says they're now using AAA batteries instead of AA's. The first page of the manual explains everything that you should have got inside the box and the real names of those things. And then the first step is to remove the protective film from the various pieces of acrylic. So let's start off. Here's all the acrylic stuff. Now you just pull this stuff off. The idea is it protects, it stops it getting scratched inside the box. So it's all nice and glossy when you get it out. It's a bit time consuming to remove it all, but it's quite therapeutic as well in a way. Now previously with these kits it's not been too good an idea to let a child do this because they've been very thin pieces of plastic. You could have snapped them when you remove the coating. As far as this kit goes, the plastic's nice and thick, or the acrylic I should say, so less likely to snap with a clumsy hand, although this one's a little bit fiddly getting the paper off here. That one tears a little bit more, but once you've cleaned it up, you'll see that that's the end plate that says Spikenzielabs Useless Machine with it etched on it. So those are all the different bits. Got it all off, so let's put those to one side. Oh, hold on. One more piece. Forgot the thingamajig. Or was that the, what do you call it? Can't remember. Right. Now, first step, we're going to put the motor on these little bracket things here. So we'll need the screws out of this bag, so let's tip all this stuff out and see exactly what we've got. Now, you've only got one of everything that you need. There's no spares in here, so if you've got anything left over at the end, you've done something wrong. But those are all the bits I need at the moment. So first thing is, the motor has to go in a certain way round. It just fits into this little plate here from this side, and that little yellow bit goes in the middle and holds it in place. So we do the same on the other side. Both plates are differently shaped, but the instructions show you which way around to put these so you can't get it wrong. So we've got them lined up now, and then I have to put the screws all the way through, but we put these little nuts on this end. They look a little bit like rivets, these, and the part that protrudes goes inside the hole. Right, so we hold those in place, and then from the other side, I've now run out of hands, so I need to put these washers on these screws. Ah, there we go. Master of invention. So that's what we need to do. We need to put the washers on the screws. Maybe I should have done that first if I'd read ahead, but we just put those screws all the way through and they go into the little nuts that are on the other side. Now I'm going to finger tighten them to start with and then tighten them up a little bit with a screwdriver, Phillips screwdriver, but not too tight, because you've got to have this so you can move it a little bit, because the next thing you do is put it down on a flat surface, make sure those things are lined up perfectly at the bottom, and then tighten them up a bit more. None of these things tighten too much, because remember, it's all plastic, you'll snap things. Right, next thing, the PCB assembly. Here it is. Now, this is the kind of thing, in some Spikenzielabs kits, they'd have you solder these things on yourself, but on this kit, they've decided just to put them on themselves, save you a bit of time, and, you know, not much that you can learn, really, soldering four or five things to that board. So that's it. It says top and bottom. Pretty easy. Now, it goes in these two little lugs at the top here. See, there's a hole either side there? Those fit in there. You can't get it the wrong way around. It just slides in there like that. Well, just about. Now, the next thing is a little bit fiddly. What you have to do is you have to secure that to the bit at the bottom. Now, I've lifted this up a little bit so you can see. There's a hole in the side there, and then you're supposed to put this nut in the hole there, and then you're supposed to screw down from the top. Now, you're going to have to put it in there, and it's supposed to just rest in that hole there. It looks Like I've done it right there. Obviously, I'll push that top down in a moment, but the screw goes from the top into that and holds the two things together. Neat little design. Through careful editing, I've made this look very easy. It works first time. These things were going everywhere. It was very fiddly. The nut thing kept falling through the hole and then the screw fell out. And it was very fiddly to do, but through the magic of editing, looks like I've done it first time. Maybe if you did this with a child, they help you put it together, they'd have smaller fingers and it'd be a little bit easier, that part. Now, next thing is I have to get the motor in the right position. It's got to face completely upright, like vertical. As you can see, mine is diagonal. So I can't twist it by hand. You're not supposed to do that. That will damage it. What you have to do is attach the battery up to the motor just for a few seconds or a couple of seconds, have it spin round. So put the batteries in the battery compartment there, three triple A's, not supplied, of course. You have to get your own. And then these two leads here, I'll attach to the two leads of the motor. Doesn't really matter which way around, I don't think, either. I'm not too sure, but I'll just show you here. I've got it angled so you can see it. There you go, the motor spins round. There you go, got it at the 12 o'clock position now. So that's exactly where it has to be for the whole thing to fit together. So the next stage is to attach the arm to it. So we need those bits out of the box there. So I've put those to one side. And the first thing is you put the washer on over the top of that. And then you put the arm on. Don't push it down all the way, just have it flush with the top, so it doesn't foul on anything. And then next stage is just to put the washer on top of that with the screw over the top of it and just put that over the top again, not tightening things in a crazy manner to snap anything, just enough to hold it together. Right, we're putting it on the base now. Feels like we're sort of getting somewhere. So put the two little bits that stick out on that base part there. And again, we're doing one of those things with the washer and the screw from the other side. Now this again kept dropping out, and it's about 50th go this when I got it in. So again, magic of editing makes it look very easy, but it is a bit fiddly doing that. Right, so that's that. Next bit, fun part, we just put it on the four sticky feet on the bottom there. So I'll just jump ahead a little bit until they're all on here, and then there we go. So one in each corner, just a little bit in from the edge. And that's it. So we've got nice rubber feet on there, and the thing's solid. We're taking off this little piece of Velcro, the sticky back part, putting that on the back of the battery compartment, taking the other sticky back part off the other side, and putting the batteries just in this right position here, just between the sort of finger part and the edge of it. Now we're going to put the wires into here. Now remember, this is a kit that doesn't need any soldering. All you have to do is use a screwdriver just to tighten them into these little block thing here. It tells you which ones to go in. The black one goes next to where it says black, the red one goes next to where it says red, rather obviously. I've taken the battery out so that nothing bad happens when I put these wires in. I don't want anything breaking while I'm putting it together. The battery from the bottom goes in the next one, and then the battery from the top goes in the last one there. Right, next step. It says test it out. Now I have tested it with the batteries in. I'm not going to show you that because I don't want to ruin the amazing surprise at the end as to what this thing does. So yes, it works, but I'll put it all together first. Next part, corner post pre-screwing. These little black pieces of plastic, they've got holes in them, but the idea is you're supposed to screw the Phillips head screws all the way in and then take them out again so that you're creating a thread inside there. Now this bit was no fun at all because I ended up with sort of hand cramp in both hands. It's very hard to hold a little tube like that and put a screw into either end, but it is necessary, but it's no fun at all. I mean, if a dad was putting this together with a child at that point, he'd probably be swearing a little bit, or trying not to anyway. And be careful with those as well. It's very easy to put a screwdriver into your hand when you're holding the thing like that. Now, when you screw these into the corners, be careful again. Don't snap the corners off of that base part. And now we're just going to assemble it like a box. So the etched part goes in on the right hand side. The part that isn't etched goes in the left hand side. And then we've got two sides that go on this to make the rest of the box. They have to go a certain way around. They're both the same, but they've got to have this part on the right hand side. This is the sort of hinge area for the box. So that goes on that side. And then this one we have to flip round, of course, because it has to match it up on the other side. And then the next bit is we put a little door into that. You can see this little tube part here, and that rests in those little indents in those sides. And then we've got to put the top on this. Now, it's a bit fiddly, this. I had a few goes, it sort of fell apart, and it's hard to get it all lined up at once. You think you've got most of it in, but then an end goes in too far or falls out or something. But a bit of patience, just coax it into place, and there we go. We've now got the box assembled as it should be. The only thing we have to do, put this little washer on the switch at the top, put a nut on top of that to hold that in place. And I'm just going to finger tighten a screw in each one of these corners just to make sure the thing doesn't fall apart again. These go in from the top. And then again, screwdriver into those. Be careful again that you don't sort of miss them and put a big scratch across it or break the corner off or something. But that's it. So let's see what it does. What was that? Press it again. What the heck? I don't... Oh, I get it now. Useless machine. You switch it on, switches itself back off again. Ah, strangely addictive. No, I want it on. Cheeky flipping on. Some people. Oh, for crying out loud. But you know what? You're going to leave this on a desk somewhere. Someone won't be able to resist flipping that switch. Now, if you want to change the batteries in this, not too difficult. Just open the door. They're there in the bottom. You can just pull them out. It pulls off that Velcro thing. Swap them out and put them back again. Can't really imagine anyone getting through three AAA alkaline batteries, but if you ever do, you can swap them out. But I just can't stop switching this switch for some reason. Just leave it there and you go, oh, flipping... I can't even... Oh, anyway. Flipping at night time, notice this. It's green when it goes up, red when it goes down again. I'll just show you with the door open. There you go, green, red. Oh, that's pretty good, isn't it? I mean, yeah, it is completely useless, but you know what? There's something strangely addictive about it. It's quite good fun. If you want to get hold of one of these, it's available from Spikenzielabs.com. Right, I'm not going to switch it again. It's ridiculous. Oh, just one more then. Duh. Anyway, that's it for the moment. As always, thanks for watching.